Okay.
And we're going to just start this morning by finding a comfortable seating position. And we're going to start with just a little bit of breath practice. So we're going to do some alternate nostril breathing and very simple alternate nostril breathing. So take your hand and bend your first two fingers in. And what we're going to do is use the thumb to close one nostril and the ring finger to close the other. And this is a different alternate nostril breathing than we've done before. I was anticipating that Jesse might be here, so I made this a very simple alternate nostril, so not to stress the body too much. So what we're going to do is close the right nostril with the thumb. Take a deep inhale. Then open both nostrils and exhale through both nostrils. And then we'll close the left nostril. Inhale and then exhale through both nostrils. So you can just gently close your eyes and move through this alternate nostril breathing for a few rounds. And then after your next exhale, just place both palms down on your knees. And just keeping your eyes closed, feel the breath moving into the body. Allow the breath to flow freely through the body. Feel almost as if the breath is breathing you. Feel the gentle inhalation and exhalation. And begin to feel your body relaxing. Muscles are starting to soften and relax from the tips of your toes, up the legs, the thighs, up your torso. Feel the neck and the head relaxing. Loosen your jaw. Let your tongue fall loosely on the floor of your mouth. Feel your ears relaxing. Feel the relaxation spreading across the shoulders, down the upper arms, down the lower arms, and into your fingertips. Feel your whole body softening and relaxing. And then very gently, we're going to start off standing this morning. And we're going to do a little bit of Dan Yoga, which is Korean yoga. So we're going to practice vibrating the body, which is going to not only relax the body, it's also going to stimulate the circulation. So find yourself a comfortable standing position, mountain pose, with the nice feet parallel. Making sure that the weight is rooted evenly on your feet so you can rock a little bit forward and back. And then feel your weight sinking into the big toe, the little toe, and both sides of the heels. Feel your knees gently pull up, hips and over the knees. You can just engage the core slightly. Bring your shoulders up to your ears and then back and just let your shoulders relax. Your head parallel, chin parallel to the floor. And try to soften around your face. So what we're going to try to do is keep the whole body soft. So we gently bend the knees, keep your heels rooted on the floor, and then we're just going to vibrate by bending the knees. Feel yourself softening with each inhale. And with each exhale, feel the vibration removing the tension from your body. Play around with the movement. You can make the movement small and go as fast as you wish. Or you can make the bend a little bit deeper and go a little slower. Begin to let your whole body get involved in the shaking. And then continuing to bend the knees and just very gently vibrating the body, take your right hand and beginning at the shoulder, all the way down your arm. So we're stimulating the body and improving the circulation. When you get to your fingertips, turn your palm upward and move back up to the top of your shoulder. Cross the collarbones and then switch arms. Back and down. Right arm. Turn your palm up. Then take both hands, tap very lightly on the top of the head, round the back of the head, relax the eyes, down to the neck, back to the top, down the sides, back to the top, tap all along the face. Around the neck, the front, sides, back of the neck. And then tap down. Tap on the lower abdomen. And then very gently, beginning at the navel, twist the body. As big as you can. Scrunch hands, your ears right up. Take your shoulders back and down. And then we'll do just one roll in the opposite direction. We spend a lot of time with our shoulders rolled forward, so this isn't something we really need to practice that too much. Now take your shoulders and start swinging your shoulders backwards, one shoulder at a time. And you can get your whole body involved, to your head, center, and once more roll your shoulders back, and this time as you roll forward, let your head come forward, and then just let your head come just a little bit back as you roll your shoulders back so that your chin is gently tipped toward the ceiling. Take a moment to feel the energy moving through your shoulders. Then we're going to release a little bit of the tension in the shoulders by just taking our fingers and just pinching and releasing the trapezius muscles. Pinch and gradually move your way from your neck down to the shoulders. So what we're doing with this pinching movement is bringing more blood into the muscle, which is going to help release the tight contraction. And then the other side, pinch, hold, about 3 seconds, release, pinching, and place them on your forehead. Very gently press into the forehead. Pull your hands out to the corners by your temples. Slide your fingers down to just in front of your ear. And then you're going to slide the palms down the front of the face to the neck, pulling down to the collarbone. So we're sliding along the lymph glands. Time, take 2 fingers, place them on your chin, pressing into your fingers. Slide them out to the corners of your mouth, up in the nasolabial fold, to the edge of your nose. Slide them up the bridge of your nose, round underneath the eye, back up over your eyebrows. Slide them down, bridge of the nose. And then take them out the cheekbones to just in front of your ear. And then add your 3rd finger, slide down the face, down the neck, to the collarbone. Just shake your fingers out. So often in yoga, we work at releasing or strengthening the muscles in the upper back and the lower back, but we don't often work on the middle back, and actually it's the middle back that gets quite tense when we're using computers or washing dishes or whatever we're doing. So we're going to work on the muscles in the mid part of the back. So tomorrow, if you have a little bit of stiffness in the side of your ribs, it's because you're using muscles we don't very often stretch this way. So what we're going to do is interlace the fingers, place the palms on top of the head. The thing to remember in this is that we're not putting any pressure on the head, we're just resting the hands here. And we're going to tip the left elbow up to the ceiling, bend the head. Now it's not a side bend, so we're just pushing the elbow up toward the ceiling. And you should feel a stretch on this part. Remember not to put any pressure on your hands. Take a deep breath. Back to center. Opposite elbow to the ceiling. Really stretch the elbow up. Back to center. Stretch. No pressure on the hand. Once more on each side, ear tipping toward the shoulder that's going down, the elbow reaching toward the ceiling. Try to keep the face and the neck soft and relaxed. Back to center. Step your feet so that if you were to go straight down from your iliac crest, from that point in the hip bone, you'd be going straight down to your feet. And make sure that your feet are parallel, toes pointing toward the window. We're going to turn the palms outward. And then very slowly inhale, lifting the arms toward the ceiling, bringing the palms together. And on the exhale, press the palms together and pull the energy down through the midline of the body. And then release the hands out to the side. Once more, inhale. You can turn to look at your palms. Press the palms together. Bring the head straight and pull the energy down the midline of the body. And once more, turn the palms outward. Slowly inhale, press the palms together, pull the energy down. So let your hands relax at the side. Take a deep breath and feel if this gentle motion has changed how the breath and the energy is moving. We're going to step our feet above hip width apart. We're going to place the left palm on the left thigh. And bring the right palm to face the window. And then inhale, bend the elbow. We know that the spine lengthens interestingly enough on the exhale. So as we exhale, we're going to slowly turn the hand, turn the palm toward the body, and allow the hand and arm to grow toward the ceiling. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, feel your spine growing taller as you relax the shoulder. And then, very gently on the exhale, begin to slide your other palm down your leg as you tip to the side. Turn your head gently to look at your upper arm. And then turn your head back down to look at the floor. And then slide your palm. So see if you can actually feel on the exhale how your spine is extending and becoming longer. So we'll turn the opposite palm outward, place the other hand on the thigh. Inhale, bend the elbow, and then on the exhale, begin to turn the palm toward the center line and curl the fingers toward the ceiling. Try to keep the shoulder from hiking up. Slowly begin to slide the palm down the standing leg, tipping to
turn to look up under your arm. And then turn the head down to look at the floor. And come up. Bring the head back to center. So by looking down at the floor when we're lifting our head, we're making sure we're not completely straight in the neck. So now we're going to bring the feet back close together. Just take a moment to feel yourself standing in mountain pose, Tadasana. Pull your navel so that you're trying to get your navel to touch the back of your spine. This will help align the pelvis. And then step your feet again, hip width apart. Turn the palms to the front of the room. And the elbows. And now take the thumbs and place each thumb in the fold of the elbow. Then try to keep that navel pressed toward the spine so that your core is engaged. Inhale. Bring your arms up. And then very gently begin hinging at your hips to tip forward. Only come forward until you feel some resistance, your body saying, that's far enough, or your back begins to round. So coming as far forward as is comfortable for you. And when you get as far forward as you would like, release your hands. Bring your palms to some place on your leg where you touch. And then on the next inhale, slide your palms up your legs as you come. And once more, we'll turn palms outward. Place the thumbs, place the opposite thumb on top. Pull the navel in toward the spine. Inhale, bring the arms up. See if you can, as your arms are up, relax your shoulders down toward the mat. And then very gently inhale, and on the exhale, hinging at the hip, begin to move forward and down until either your back begins to round or you feel a place of resistance. And then let your hands drop onto your legs. And then begin to slide the palms up your legs. Stand with your legs above hip width apart. Bring your arms out to the side and then bring your arms in to your chest. Now, moving the arm and the right leg at the same time, take a step out, open the arm, make sure your foot is parallel, and then open the other arm, which you can step. So you're in a really nice wide stance. From this stance, bring your hands to your hips. Turn your right toe in. Turn your left toe out. If you have a problem with your knees, you have any knee pain, you can slightly bend your front knee, but if your knees are okay, just keep your legs straight. And now the same movement we did, bending, hinging at the hips, and just coming forward. Pause for one complete breath in the forward position. And then come back up. Straighten. Turn your feet in. And step back. Parallel. Let your hands rest for a moment. chest. This time we'll step wide with the left foot, arm, wide, right foot, arm. Turn the left foot in, right foot out. Bring your hands to your hips. Straighten your hips so that your hips are facing the short end of your mat. Then very gently, leading with your heart, inhale and then begin to fold forward, keeping your back straight. You're not rounding your back. And if you have any problems with your knees, you can gently bend your knee. And then come up. Just turn. Just take a moment to relax. You can probably see we're working Jesse up into the warrior pose. And now just come down to sitting on your mat. Let's take a moment to feel energy moving through your body. Sitting bones moving down. See if you can bring your awareness to the spine around the area of your navel. See if you can feel how on each inhalation and exhalation, the lower part of your body is moving down toward the earth, and the upper part of the body is moving upward. So your spine is actually moving in two directions. Open your eyes. Come back up to standing. So we're going to look at Baxter Bell's balance pose for this week, which is called the Four Quarters. I'll just demonstrate it for you, and then you can try it two or three times yourself. So the first part of this Four Quarters is quite easy. We're going to take the right foot and step to the right corner of the mat, and you can let your heel lift a little, and then step back. And then the left foot to the left corner, right way as far to the corner as you can. Your heel can lift, and then back. Looking back behind, step your right foot to the right corner. Push your heel, doesn't want to lift this time, so it stays rooted on the mat. And back to center, and then your left foot left corner, and back to center. If you need to, feel free to use your arms to balance and move through the four corners one more time at your own pace. And the more your body is struggling for balance and trying to keep you upright, the more you're rewiring your brain, your neurosurgery. So this wouldn't be a Baxter Bell pose unless it was actually a challenge that had you falling over or had us falling over. So what we're going to do now is the opposite leg to the opposite corner. So we're going to begin by taking the right leg to the left corner. Leg to the right corner, back, right leg to the left corner, back, and you can use your arms to keep you back. And then once more at your own pace, opposite foot.
take a moment to catch your breath. Feel how your feet are rooting firmly into the mat. And see if you feel like you've actually grown a little bit taller. And then we'll come down to sitting on the mat again. So the next piece that we're going to do comes from somatic yoga, and we're going to do a hip release that comes from Thomas Hammer's work. So we're going to sit, we're going to take one leg back in this position, and the other leg with the foot kind of resting on the thigh. So somatic yoga is based on a principle called pandiculation, which I actually hadn't heard of. I wasn't sure what pandiculation was. And then I realized that we all do it every morning. And in fact, when my little dog is stretching before she gets up in the morning, she's not actually stretching, she's pandiculating. So what pandiculation is it's a voluntary contraction of a muscle, like when we're yawning, and then a lengthening of the muscle, and then a complete release of the muscle. So what this does is not actually, doesn't just stretch and improve the muscle, it's actually rewiring the brain. And it's sort of like the hottest thing in sports medicine right now, because they've discovered that stretching doesn't actually improve athletic performance. So it's actually very simple. We're going to take one hand, place it behind knee that's bent in the front. And there's three different ways you can put your palm. You can put your palm flat on the mat. If you have a little bit of weakness in your wrist or you'd like to strengthen your wrist, you can take your fingers up into this kind of steeple, spider position. Or if it's more comfortable, you can make a fist. You just rest on your fist. I'm not going to be putting a lot of weight on this particular arm, so you might want to just play with a different. We're going to take the opposite hand, put it on the knee. We're going to slowly lift the knee up while pressing down with the hand. So it's actually, you're pressing against your own strength, but the knee is going to kind of win the pressure contest and it's going to rise up. And then we're going to use this same pressure and push the knee down, and this time hand is going to push the knee down and then totally relax the muscle. And you'll feel there's, we're working the abductors and the adductors into the lower muscle and the top of the thigh. So once more, pressing into the knee, lift the knee, slowly. Third time, lift the knee, waist, and then completely relax. Is that hurting your ankle? Maybe you could take, go sideways on your mat, and roll your mat and put it up. If it's hurting in the hip here, that's tight, see if you can put your leg, your foot closer to the back of your body.
I'm noticing that the ankle is a problem.
Make sure that you flex your foot. Does that help a little?
Yes.
Okay. Now we're going to take the arm and place it on the opposite knee. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to lift this knee, pressing against the palm. Slowly pressing it down and then completely relax. So hand on the knee, voluntary contraction as we pull the knee up, pushing down, which is lengthening those upper leg muscles across the hips, and then completely relax. Once more,
lifting. Now take two fingers, put the two fingers on your back heel. This time we're going to press the big toe into the mat as we lift the heel up against the pressure of the fingers, and then very slowly press the heel down, and then relax the foot. Once more, lifting the heel, pressing the big toe into the mat. Push the heel down against the heel's resistance. And then release completely. One more time, pressing the big toe. Lift the heel, contracting. And then pressing down, the heel down toward the mat, lengthening the muscle. Then release. Shake. And we'll move over to the other side. Make sure that the back leg is, back foot is flexed so you're protecting your knee. So take the leg that you have straight and bend it.
I'm trying to remember which way I am.
Maybe we'll have to put them on this table.
Okay, and then press against the thigh. If you're finding this easy to do, you can make it more challenging by bringing your leg out here. But I think we'll just keep it. Okay, and then we'll place the left hand, the left knee, the other hand behind, up on your fingertips, your flat on your palm, and your knuckle. And then begin by lifting the knee against the pressure of your arm, contracting the muscles of the leg and into the hip, and then pressing down, lengthening the muscle, and then release. Inhale, lift. Make sure you keep breathing as you're doing this lifting and lowering. It's a tendency when you're doing something that's unusual to hold your breath. Make sure you're using the breath to help the muscle. And then release completely. And lift. Fingers to the heel. Make sure your foot is flexed so you're protecting the feet. Press the big toe into the mat and against the resistance of your fingers, lift the heel. And then lengthen the muscle by lowering the heel with the fingers that your foot resists. And then release. Once more, lift. Bring your legs up on the mat. Shake your legs out. And you can take your hands and just rub down the muscles like this.
you're familiar with the work of Peter Levine, is there some of the things that he does? Working with somatic energy. So now we'll come gently down onto the back. Bend your knees so that your knees are pointing toward the ceiling. Inhale, bring your right knee to the chest, and then cross your right ankle over the left thigh. Place both of your palms on top of your left thigh, and as you inhale, lift your left knee up off the ground, flexing both feet so the toes are pointing to the ceiling, and let your hands slide around the back of your thigh to interlace behind the thigh. Inhale, exhale. Using your right elbow, you can gently guide your knee out toward the side, keeping both feet flexed. Release your hands and take your arms out to the T on the side of your body. Inhale, and on the next exhale, very gently roll over toward the left so that your left thigh and the sole of your right foot come to the floor. Your hip will lift. If you need to lift your arm and shoulder, you can do that as well. Now reach down with your left hand and take a hold of your right ankle. Take your right arm, and if your arm is at pointing out toward 9 o'clock, slide it up along the floor as if you were a clock so that you're pointing at 11 o'clock. Using your muscle power, gently push your right knee away from your body. Feel a lovely stretch that goes from the tips of your outstretched arm right across the knee. And more than likely, you'll feel the stretch in the piriformis muscle along the right knee. Take a nice deep inhale. Imagine that your lungs are situated right in your hips so that you're bringing lots of fresh blood, oxygen into the muscle. And then slide your right arm down back toward your body. Let go of your ankle. Slide your fingertips underneath the arch of your right foot. And then on the next inhale, very gently inhale and guide your knees back up to center. Uncross your legs. Put both feet on the mat, knees pointing toward the ceiling, and then just let your knees gently rock from side to side to bring your spine and your hips back into a neutral position. And then bring your knees back to center, pointing to the ceiling. Inhale your left knee up toward your chest, and then cross your left foot over your right thigh. Flex your left foot so you're protecting your ankle. Place the palms on the right thigh, and as you inhale, inhale the right knee up toward the chest. Slide your palms around the back and interlace your fingers behind your thigh. On each inhale, you can perhaps bring your knees a little closer to your chest, and you can use your left elbow to gently suggest to your left knee that it move outward. Keep your tailbone rooted on the ground. There's a tendency to want to lift your hips up, but try to keep them on the mat. And then release your arms out to the side, T-shape. Palms facing toward the ceiling, and then very gently tip your legs over to the right so that your right thigh and the sole of your left foot come onto the floor. Slide your left arm up to that 11 o'clock position and feel the energy moving from your shoulder right up through the tips of your fingers, and then reach down with your right hand and take a hold of your left ankle. You might find that your ankle is closer or farther away from your body than the other side, or all asymmetrical. And then very gently, using your muscular power, push your left knee toward the wall. And feel the diagonal stretch from the knee to the tips of the fingers. And you should feel a really nice stretch in the hip area. Breathe deeply, bringing lots of oxygen into the muscle. And then slide your upper arm down around so it's lying at the side of your body. Let go of your ankle. Place your fingertips underneath the arch of your foot. And then very gently bring the whole leg configuration up to center. Uncross your knees. This time we're going to inhale. The knees up to the chest, wrap your arms around your knees, give yourself a nice squeeze, and then release and let your knees come down so that your feet are flat on the floor. Slide both legs out straight with your knees, your legs about hip width apart. And just feel yourself settle into the mat. Now slide both of your legs together so that your ankles and your feet are touching each other. And very gently begin to tap your big toes together. So tap your toes together and apart. Tap quite quickly. And as your legs begin to relax and your hips begin to release, allow your feet to move out in larger arcs as you're tapping. Tap quickly. And what we're doing with this is not only vibrating the body, but we're pulling the energy down into the lower part, the lower limbs. This has a very calming effect. And bring your feet to stillness. Slide your heels apart from each other so that your legs are about a little more than hip distance apart. Roll your toes in towards each other and then roll them out so your toes are pointing away from your body, opposite sides. And then once more roll the toes toward each other and then roll. Roll your palms up toward the ceiling and then back down to the floor, up toward the ceiling. And this time we'll roll the palms down to the floor and we'll keep the palms facing the floor. And then just gently rock along the occipital bone, so shifting your head gently from left to right. And then let your head come to stillness. Your nose pointing up to the ceiling. Just tuck your chin slightly so that your chin isn't jutting up in the air. Take a deep inhale. Exhale. Make
beginning at your toes, begin to contract and tighten the muscles from the toes, right up the legs, right up the torso, from the fingers up the arms, up to the shoulders, scrunch your face all up, tighten all of the muscles in your body, and then relax everything. And once more, see if you can feel the tightening begin at the toes and move like a wave right up the body, till every muscle in your body, including your eyes, your nose, your mouth, jaw, tense, and relax. Once more, tighten. Relax. Sink down to the mat. Feel your breath begin to deepen. Take a nice deep inhale, filling the lungs from the bottom to the middle of the lungs to the very top of the lungs. Feel the prana, the life force, the energy moving, flowing into the body with each breath. Feel tension leaving the body with each exhalation. Bring a little bit of movement to your fingertips and your toes. Wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. Slide your legs together so that your heels and your toes are touching. And the next inhale, bend your knees. Bring your knees up to your chest. Wrap your arms around your knees. Give yourself one of those famous yoga. And then very gently rock from side to side on the spine. Eventually taking your right arm off your knee and bending it by the side of your head. And roll over onto the right side. Your arm is a little pillow. And just take a moment to feel the energy moving through your body. Feel gratitude. Appreciation for the movement, for the presence on the mat, and for the kindness that you've offered yourself with this practice this morning. And then when you're ready, very gently bring yourself up to sitting. Take the palms out to the side. Together, lifting the elbows, press your fingers into one another, and release. Relax your shoulders. Thank you for practicing with me this morning.
Thank you.